With that, the butcher began the story of the contest of generosity.
It is related
in Baghdad of a boy and a girl who loved each other from an infancy.
Boys unite in the Rawa Valley, where the wind is good and the breeze is cool.
But while the fortune of the boy's family rose, that of the girl's fell.
Beloved, have you heard? My father and mother are forced to marry me to a sheikh that I've never met. Beloved, had you heard?
No.
I must leave tonight.
Then you must go now. It's growing dark.
What do you mean? It is midday. Can't you see the sun?
No. It's growing dark.
What do you see?
Nothing. The sun rises in your eyes, and the moon sleeps in the hollow of your neck. I've heard that you are going, and I'm growing blind from grief.
Say what's in your heart.
A desert.
And so she said,
as the poet says, when you passed on by my tent door, I said goodbye to all the world, forgetting how to love forevermore when you passed on. If you come back the way you went, I pray take my body up and set it in a calm grave near your tent when you come back. And if your dear voice recalls the tones and the sweetness of the way you said my name, kneel down, dear Lord, and say the same, and I will answer with the clicking of my bones. Farewell.
Farewell. Cheeks of surf the silver, golden wrists with copper bangles. Lake hair lying in black angles. Dreams are pictures in the book of sleep, and no more mine. And no more mine forever.
Surely when a bride weeps as young girls do, because she misses her mother. Happily, this does not last long. A kind word will cure her. O light of my soul, why do you destroy the beauty of your eyes? Dear girl, if you are crying for your mother, tell me, and I will fetch her to you instantly. Your father? A cat or a gazelle? Tell me, and you will no longer be separated from your desire. The house where you were young? Tell me, and I will take you there instantly.
My lord, I do not weep for my father, my mother, or my pets, and I beg you
because I'm repugnant to you.
No. By law, I have no aversion to you. It's something else.
What then?
My grief and tears are for a dear one of my house, a cousin with him I grew up, a cousin who loves me and whom I love. Oh, master, love's roots are in the heart, and when love is torn away, then the heart is torn away also.
The Sheikh lowered his head and reflected for an hour.
Dear mistress, the law of Allah forbids one believer from snatching even a single mouthful of bread from another by force. So then how could I snatch away your heart? Rise up, my pride of a minute, and go with my full consent to your cousin. Return in the morning before the servants are awake. From now on, this is how we shall live. You are as my daughter.
A blessing be upon you.
She left that good man's house, glowing in the night in her happiness and wedding jewels.
By Allah, my lucky night, a wedding guest in all her jewels.
Give me all your jewels and I'll snatch you to the earth.
Just when everything was going so well. Just when everything was going so well, and I was going home to the one I love.
What wedding were you at?
My own. But when I told the Sheikh that I loved another, the good man let me go.
He let you go?
Yes, but now I've fallen into your hands, and a thief is not like a Sheikh.
Where does your love live?
In a room on a garden in such street in such house.
Dear mistress, no one shall ever accuse a person of my profession of interfering with the course of true love. I will lead you to your lover's house.
So saying, the robber escorted her as if she had been a queen up to the house.
By Allah, I can see. Whose hands are these?
Beloved?
Who are you to speak to me?
Your love.
What have you done? How have you...
She explained to him all of her adventures on this strange night,
but nothing would be gained by repeating it in this place.
What a generous man this Sheikh. I must return you to the saint at once.
What?
My love, do you agree?
In the face of such virtue, what else can we do?
Children, do not tell me why you are here. I have already guessed, but you must know this. You owe me nothing. I am in bondage to my oath.
So saying, the good man gave his house and all his goods to the two of them and went to live in another city.
So now, Prince of Tar, let us stop and consider. Who was the most generous? Was it the lover? Or was it the thief? Or what about the husband?
They're all idiots.
Well, then we'll judge for ourselves. Was it the lover?